Good morning, I'm Edrick Luy, and we are at the Gawad Kalinga Enchanted Farm. Here we are, on the red carpet workshop. My group and I came here in hopes that we could learn something more about the red carpet industry. I have a few questions.
Okay.
So, what is Gawad Kalinga?
For me, Gawad Kalinga is really a articulation of our a vision to take this country out of poverty by 2024. It's really a platform for us young people to stake our future in as businessmen or as whatever profession, medical or engineers, there's something here in Gawad Kalinga that we can really invest in ourselves and also for future generation, our children.
What brought you to this place?
I'm a business major, so I study business.
Yep.
Since this is so linked with this whole initiative is really linked with business, it's very attractive for me.
So why did you choose to stay
here in the farm?
Yeah, the farm.
I think it's really the only movement that's really articulating a grand vision to take this country out of poverty. At the same time, it's really it's so vast and multi-sectoral. You connect with all sorts of people.
Yeah.
So it's really something that not many organizations or movements or initiatives are doing.
What are your visions for this community, for Gawad Kalinga?
I'd say simply, and which is actually happening, is for people to see a beauty, a magic of being Filipinos when they come here to the site.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's one of the slogans of the site.
Yeah.
And to see everything good about being Filipino when they come here.
Yeah.
Be really inspired. When they come here, and so that means, you know, showcasing excellence, showcasing hard work, all the traits that we really pride ourselves in being Filipino. So which means that the community has to show that, which they are, you know, which many people already see.
Yeah. So to you, what is red carpet?
To go back a bit, I'd say the goal really for red carpet was always to employ the most people.
Yeah.
And since sewing is such a common skill in our community, it seems like such a wonderful way to create bottom of the pyramid level.
Yeah.
So there's lots of opportunities to help people. At the same time, the industry is so underdeveloped here in the Philippines that there's so much room to innovate, so much room to create new things, new exciting things, like designs, create things like
that. So why did you choose red carpet?
I have an appreciation for design, so as a hobby, I do graphic design. So it somewhat interested me now that I could, you know, design things and make it into a real product. And then, you know, the people also working with red carpet prior to me, our close friends also. I enjoy the environment, also enjoy the work. Again, like the opportunity to help people is really present.
how would you take red carpet to the next level?
Well, one of our strategies is to really connect with established designers. Not just established designers, but talented designers. That they can really put out their talents and the products and make something really different. It's very Filipino, and then we can really showcase that. So we showcase the designer, the Filipino designer. We also showcase the craftsmanship of the Filipino. And we can really create quality, different, innovative products here locally. And then hopefully, you know, the more we market it, the more we spread the word to people, we can really scale up to be like something like Bench.
Yeah.
But really a authentically local version, you know, that doesn't just print shirts that say Filipino, but actually it's made in the Philippines. Yeah. Really everything about it is pro-Philippine. So you feel good about wearing it.
Yeah.
It also won't be like a pity thing when you're buying your clothes because out of pity, but also because it's cool. Yeah. It's different. And that's what we're also trying. It's very new. What we're trying to do with our canvas bags, our jute canvas bags. We're trying to do with some of our accessories, home furnishing items.
So how do you see, where do you see red carpet in the near future?
Well, in the near future, I think for us as a business to really grow, we need to just focus on getting contract sewing jobs.
Yeah.
So we're just looking for that so we can sort of, you know, build up our production facility, the business itself. So that's one of our short term focuses as entrepreneurs. But then moving down, we also really want to focus more on retailing our own product, designing and producing our own products. So that will really be different.
So any other words for you to say for aspiring social entrepreneurs to promote compassion for the less fortunate, at the same time sustaining their development and innovation for our country using our God-given natural resources?
Well, for aspiring entrepreneurs, I think that there's real value in dreaming, not just dreaming for yourself, but also dreaming for others. And then putting that together with what we're doing here in GK. What CSI GK is doing is giving us the opportunity to really give out that kind of dream, to provide to fulfill our own needs, you know, as obviously wealth creation is something good and also something that can help people. So dream big and do it, and dream for others. That is what really will make it fulfilling.
Thank you so much for your time. Appreciate it.
Red Carpet is a social enterprise that was founded by a social entrepreneur in Gawad Kalinga, offering superb quality curtains, pillowcases, and jute bags, highlighting the undervalued sewing skills of the women living in Gawad Kalinga communities to make hand-stitched, soft, and lovely products, and at the same time, providing a sustainable livelihood to the people living in the community, and in turn, allowing their children in Bulacan to eat and go to school every day. With this given information, social entrepreneurship promotes authentic development by not only making an innovative product for their own business, but also giving job opportunities to the less fortunate to meet their own needs.
Like what Rich said earlier, in Gawad Kalinga,
the social entrepreneurs make the effort to give the less fortunate job opportunities and share their profit to them so they can make a living and provide for themselves or for their families. Social entrepreneurs do not only care for the profit they make, but also for the welfare of the people who are in need, and most especially the poorest and the most neglected in society, thus promoting authentic development.
Through the hard work, dedication, and passion of the social entrepreneurs, I observe that they have managed to work amongst each other under one roof, which in turn results in publicizing their cause of obtaining authentic development even more. This is an advantage, especially since through raising awareness, people will take notice of their products, and so the proceeds will further help the families and their children in their education and living.
Here at Red Carpet, the social entrepreneurs make it a point that all their products and methods in making them are sufficient for their needs and eco-friendly, so that in an unlikely event of having excess or unused materials, it may be recycled and be used for future purposes. This promotes sustainable development because it meets the needs of the present time without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. Since pollution and the depletion of natural resources are rising issues in contemporary time, as it fosters sustainability, it in turn promotes authentic development.
For me, authentic development is subdivided into other branches. One of them is integral development. In integral development, people, especially the entrepreneurs, don't focus on the profit that they get from the business. Most people would think that business is all about the money. But for some of the entrepreneurs, like the ones here in GK and Red Carpet, they really balance the profit in helping others as their motives for their businesses. These entrepreneurs want to promote the welfare of people's morals, spirituality, and mentality, and many more. These entrepreneurs want to reach out to the people who are neglected in society and help them in achieving their own dreams.